Duke Engineering has a long history. It actually dates back to the late 19th century, before Duke University was Duke University. When there was only Trinity College, there was engineering within Trinity College in the late 1890s, and I think there were a grand total of two engineering professors at that point. But the College of Engineering per se was started in 1939, so it was about a dozen years after the start of Duke University per se that engineering was formally recognized as a separate school, and there became a dean whose name was William Holland Hall, and he got the whole thing started. I remember the class of 1942, came back for their 50th reunion in 1992, and a very high proportion of the class returned for that. And they reminded me that when they were at Duke, they lived on East Campus, and the people who were living on East Campus were all the engineering students, who were entirely male, plus all the women. Because at one time, Duke had a women's college. Women didn't actually graduate in engineering at Duke until the class of 46. And there was a grand total of two women, Marie Foote and Muriel Theodorson Williams. And I met both of them. In fact, their portraits are over on East Campus. When I came in 83, one of the great attractors was the quality of the undergraduate student body. Duke even then had one of the best undergraduate populations in engineering in the country, which was a fairly well-kept secret, except those who actually are in the business. And I remember having a call from a colleague from another university that said, "How did Duke do that?" And I said, "I have no idea, but it's a great thing." Well, in 1983, I arrived as the new dean of engineering. The tier building was literally coming out of the ground when I arrived. We had these excellent undergraduates, we had some excellent faculty, and we had a fairly modest graduate student body. And what we needed to do is create a modern school of engineering that had a substantial and excellent graduate program to go along with the excellent undergraduate program that we already had in place. I think it's recognized that we now have a very strong graduate and research activity in addition to the historically strong undergraduate population, and it's been a great success story.